This one-year forward rate, F1, let's review how it was derived. This is how it was derived. If money is invested domestically, we take our $1 and multiply it by 1 plus RUSA. If money is invested overseas, then we take our $1, first convert it into the foreign currency by multiplying by the exchange rate, S0, and then we add the interest rate to it. So we multiply it by 1 plus the interest rate in the foreign country. And then we divide the whole thing by the one-year forward rate, F1, to convert that overseas investment back from the foreign currency into the US dollar. Let's simplify it by getting rid of $1 on the left-hand side and on the right-hand side. So we have 1 plus RUSA equals S0 times 1 plus R foreign country, and then the whole thing on the right-hand side divided by the one-year forward rate, F1. Then we can rearrange it, and it will look like this. F1 equals S0 times 1 plus R foreign country divided by 1 plus R USA. Or let's rewrite it the way that fits sort of the definition of the so-called interest rate parity formula, where it says that the one-year forward rate divided by the spot exchange rate today equals 1 plus the interest rate in the foreign country for the risk-free asset divided by 1 plus the rate for the risk-free asset in the United States. So this is kind of the definition of the so-called interest rate parity formula that kind of comes out of the example that we just looked at, which shows how the forward rate should be determined in order for there to be sort of balanced investments across different countries. Let's do a little bit more rearrangement to this formula. Let's take this formula, the interest rate parity formula, and write an approximate version of it, where the right-hand side of it is simplified to 1 plus, and then we have the difference between the foreign and the domestic risk-free rates. One more rearrangement. So there are a whole bunch of them here, right? And this will be the last one that actually fits what we had at the very beginning when we started this whole topic on the interest rate parity. So this formula can be further rearranged to F1 minus S0. The difference is divided by S0. So it's the percentage difference between the forward exchange rate and the spot exchange rate. And on the right-hand side, what we have remaining from this rearrangement is the difference in the interest rates. The foreign interest rate for the risk-free asset minus the domestic interest rate for the risk-free asset. So this is kind of where, you know, this definition of the interest rate parity is coming from. The difference in interest rates between two countries is equal to the percentage difference between the forward exchange rate and the spot exchange rate. I lied. We are rearranging it again. Okay. There are so many different ways to write the same format, depending on what you leave on the left-hand side, which, like, notation and what you decide to keep on the right-hand side. So we're rearranging it one last time as follows. 1 year forward rate, F1, that's all we have on the left-hand side, equals today's spot exchange rate, S0, multiplied by, open parentheses, 1 plus the difference between the foreign country's risk-free rate and the US risk-free rate. Close parenthesis. This is the approximate interest rate parity. And by the way, I have an example coming up on the next slide on both the approximate and the exact interest rate parity formulas. So this formula calculates what the 1 year forward rate that you're locking in today should be depending on what today's exchange rate is, S0, and how the risk-free rates differ between the foreign and the domestic countries. But we don't have to limit ourselves to the calculation of the forward rate for 1 year. We can also use this formula and kind of generalize it to find the forward rate 1 year from now, 2 years from now, 3 years from now. So any time t in the future. All we do is determine the parentheses in this formula. We raise it to the power t, which shows that future time. In real life, forward exchange rates don't typically go beyond 1 year forward rates. Like on one of the earlier slides where I was explaining how exchange rates are quoted and showed you that table from the Wall Street Journal, you probably all only remember seeing the 1 month, the 3 month, and the 6 month forward rates. So anything beyond 1 year forward rates kind of, you know, does not really exist in real life. And that's because how would you be sure you're locking in the right exchange rate today that would be used in, let's say, 2 years, in 3 years? It's such a long amount of time that nobody would want to bet on what the exchange rate might be at such distant future time.